Hi, my name is Josh. You can find me on Twitter at FYFJosh, and today I am putting together the top 46 wide receivers into rest of season tiers going into week 9. And I have 5 tiers here. I have the elites. These players separate themselves from the pack with their elite production almost every week. I have the must-starts. These players are in your fantasy lineups every week, no questions asked. The great starts. These players are great wide receiver twos for your fantasy team, still probably starting them most weeks. The solid starts. These players are great fantasy assets, but you do not need to start them every week. And finally, the flex plays. Most of these players are pretty boom or bust options, but they still offer fantasy value for your teams. So without further ado, let's get right in there. So we are starting with the elite tier here. And I would like to first start with Cooper Kupp. He has had almost an historic wide receiver season so far. If he keeps up this pace, he will have the best wide receiver season ever in history. It is a 17-game season, but Cooper Kupp is doing amazing things. Second, I do want to put in Davante Adams. Davante Adams absolutely deserves to be in the elite tier. He's not going to have Aaron Rodgers this week, but even so, I bet you he has a great week 9. And then finally, Tyreek Hill. There's only 3 players in the elite tier in my mind. Now, moving on to the must-starts, the first player I would like to put into the must-start category is Ja'Marr Chase. Ja'Marr Chase is a rookie, but he has done everything and more that we expected coming into this season. Then Justin Jefferson. Justin Jefferson had an outstanding rookie year last year, and he's just continued on this pace. He's a fantastic receiver. Play him every week. Then Stephon Diggs. Where is he? Stephon Diggs, he's red here. Stephon Diggs absolutely belongs in the must-start category still. I know a lot of people are disappointed with his production, but he has more upside than most wide receivers out there, and he's tied to Josh Allen. Debo Samuel, this guy's been a surprise this year, right? But he is a must-start now. He has produced every week, almost every week so far this season. After Debo Samuel, I'm going to throw in CD Lamb. Tied to Dak Prescott, elite talent, love CeeDee Lamb. A.J. Brown, people were concerned about him earlier in the season, but he has proven that he is an elite wide receiver talent. However, the offense does like to run a lot. Let's see what changes now that Derrick Henry is not going to be there. Next, we're putting in DeAndre Hopkins. DeAndre Hopkins' yards and catches have concerned me so far this season, but he's an elite talent, and he plays with Kyler Murray. As long as the touchdowns keep coming, he's going to be a must-start the rest of the year. This tier is a little bit bigger than most of the tiers I'm going to be creating today, by the way. After DeAndre Hopkins is Keenan Allen. He just had his best game of the season in a PPR league, and he can catch everything. Then DK Metcalf, even with Geno Smith, he has been playing outstanding. Once Russell Wilson comes back, he only elevates himself even more. Then followed by Terry McLaurin, he's just a consistent producer for his team. Deontay Johnson after Terry McLaurin, especially in a PPR league, Deontay Johnson just separates himself with his targets and catches. DJ Moore, he's been a little bit disappointing the last couple of weeks, but he is still a must-start wide receiver. Chris Godwin. Antonio Brown has been out the last week. He's missed a couple weeks so far this season. When Antonio Brown's out, Chris Godwin is maybe the top of the must-start tier. You want to start him regardless of Antonio Brown's playing or not. And then last person in this list is Mike Evans. Yes, another Tampa Bay Buccaneer. Now moving on to the great starts. I'm sure I'm going to get a little bit of heat for this one, but I am putting Amari Cooper in great start, not must start. I think CeeDee Lamb has taken over as the one on that team. I know Amari Cooper just had a fantastic week with Cooper Rush, but he's been inconsistent so far this season, Amari Cooper. So I'm putting him in the great start category. And then after Amari Cooper here, we're going to put Cordarrelle Patterson. I know you can play him at wide receiver and running back in a lot of leagues, but he is killing it. And now without Calvin Ridley playing for the foreseeable future, I think Cordarrelle Patterson is even more important for that offense. Then I'm going to put Mike Williams. He started the year on fire, but he's had some inconsistent weeks. That's why he lands in the great start category. After Mike Williams, I will put Michael Pittman. He looks like the wide receiver one and the safety blanket for the Colts and Carson Wentz. Michael Pittman was a rookie last year. He had a fine season, and this looks to be his breakout season. I want Michael Pittman on all the fantasy teams I can get him on. Marquise Brown, he's also had a breakout season of sorts for himself. He's finally putting it all together. Let's see if he can continue getting the target share that he's been getting throughout the season. After Marquise Brown is Adam Thielen. Love Adam Thielen this year. He's a great start every week. Then Robert Woods. Yes, we were concerned about Robert Woods early in the season, but he's finally more involved in this offense. And then Antonio Brown. Antonio Brown could be in the must-start category, but he's been dealing with injuries, and we just do not know when he's going to come back. So that's why he is in the great start category for the rest of the season. That is going to end the great start wide receivers for me. Now moving on to solid starts. We are going to start this tier off with Chase Claypool. I was tempted to put Chase Claypool in the great starts. I am higher on Chase Claypool than most people, but if we're being honest, he belongs in the solid start category. He is not a guy you need to put in your lineup every week. I am now going to put in Brandon Cooks. Again, he could be in the great start category, but his offense and just the problems that they are dealing with do concern me, but he is getting so many targets, so many catches. He is the guy for that the Texans offense. So he's a borderline great start, but he falls into the solid start category. Tyler Lockett, he just had a great game with Geno Smith, I know, but him without Russell Wilson concerns me. I do not feel like you need to put him in your lineup week in and week out. He's a boom or bust option, more or less, but when he booms, he really does boom. And once Russell Wilson comes back, I'm going to feel a lot more comfortable about Tyler Lockett. He'll probably end up in the great start category once that does happen. Then we're going to put in T. Higgins. Love T. Higgins' talent. And Joe Burrow continues to get better. Cortland Sutton, he would be in the great start category if it wasn't for Jerry Jeudy coming back. And Cortland Sutton had a bad game last week with Jerry Jeudy's first game back. Speaking of Jerry Jeudy, he also is going to go in the solid start category for me. I love this guy's talent, and he has a different skill set than Cortland Sutton. He's a better route runner, but I still want Jerry Jeudy on my team, and I do think you can start him. Followed by Jerry Jeudy is a rookie, Jalen Waddle. Love what I've seen out of Jalen Waddle so far this season, and then another rookie, Devonta Smith. Jalen Waddle, Devonta Smith, both great rookies, being overshadowed by Ja'Marr Chase a little bit, but if you look at what they've done, what they produced so far this season, they are great, solid fantasy options. And that is going to end the flex play category for me. The solid starts category for me. And now we're going to go into flex plays, and we are going to start the flex plays out with Emmanuel Sanders. Emmanuel Sanders, Buffalo Bills wide receiver. He's had a fantastic season, but he's a little bit inconsistent. He didn't have a catch last week, so that absolutely hurts him. Followed by Kadarius Toney. We are going to put Kadarius Toney in here. Sterling Shepard looks like he's going to miss some time with his injury. And if Kadarius Toney can finally get healthy, he has proven that he is an elite. He can be an elite talent. He is super explosive. I like Kadarius Toney. I love his upside. You do not have to put him in your lineup, but he's got to be on your team. We're going to follow Kadarius Toney up with Marvin Jones. While he's been a little disappointing, you can't really trust him. I still believe that he is a solid flex play. Corey Davis, he didn't play last week, but he is the Jets' best wide receiver, in my opinion. Julio Jones, like I mentioned earlier, no more Derrick Henry. Let's see what happens with Julio Jones. The Titans might become more of a pass-heavy offense. Hunter Renfrow and Bryan Edwards, I'm throwing them both in here. Hunter Renfrow is a safer bet for catches. I think Bryan Edwards has a lot of upside, especially with the Ruggs news that has recently came out. Cole Beasley goes in the flex play category. He's a great PPR option. You can put him in your lineup. He has a lower ceiling, but Josh Allen sometimes does lock onto him if he can only find the right game where he's going to get, 10 targets. Cole Beasley could make it up to the solid or great star category, but right now he's a flex play. Devontae Parker, he just came back from injury last week, got 12 targets, I believe. Devontae Parker is a great flex play. Jacoby Myers, great PPR. He can't score touchdowns, but he's getting a lot of targets and receptions. Jarvis Landry. I really like Jarvis Landry's upside, especially with Odell Beckham concerns right now. We do not know if he's going to even be playing for the Browns going forward. And if Jarvis Landry is the wide receiver one, he's definitely worth a start. Tyler Boyd, he's the third option on the Bengals behind T. Higgins and Ja'Marr Chase. Now, if either one of those guys were to miss time, I think Tyler Boyd becomes much more valuable. He's fine on a weekly basis. You can throw him into your lineup. And finally, Van Jefferson. Van Jefferson is playing a lot. The Rams just released DeSean Jackson. I think Van Jefferson, I think the Rams really want to use him. And he's actually closer to Robert Woods than a lot of people really realize. So get Van Jefferson on your team. He has a ton of upside. So those are the tiers I wanted to go through. I hope you enjoyed this. I know I did. Have a great day.